What's your most embarrassing adult story? Story 1. My girlfriend and I went on a picnic by canoe out to an island where there would have been no one around for at least a few kilometers. Long story short, she started giving me a favor with her mouth, which went on for a few minutes until I started to hear a strange noise getting louder. All of a sudden, a search and rescue helicopter flies over the tree line and comes to a stop above us. It stayed there for a few seconds before flying around and flying back in the direction it came from. Story 2. Once dated a chef, and one night when he made me dinner, he went way too heavy on the cayenne pepper to season the chicken with his bare hands, if you see where this is going. Later, things got steamy, and within 2 seconds of us getting touchy, I jumped up screaming in pain as it feels like someone opened up the gates of hell in me. I spent the next hour hovering over the bidet while flushing out my area with milk, and we're laughing about it until his roommate decides to open the bathroom door without knocking and just stares at us. Yikes! I mean, I get the use of the bidet, and bidets are amazing if anyone has never tried one, but is the milk really supposed to help? I mean, I would feel weird just pouring who knows how old milk onto and around your crotch. I guess that might be the price you have to pay to make the pain and sting go away. I wonder if this couple now made a new pre-adult time routine of washing each other's hands very thoroughly before getting intimate. Doesn't seem like a mistake that you'd want to repeat. Story 3. Was home for summer from college. My neighbor and I had been secretly hooking up for a little bit, and she had been over a few days before when my parents were gone. Came home one day, and my mom was staring daggers at me. She said, "You have a mess to clean up, because I'm not doing it." I had no clue what she was talking about. Then she said to go look under the dining room table. Underneath it was a used rubber that I had thrown into the bathroom trash can wrapped in toilet paper. My dog thought it would be cool to bring it downstairs and chew on it under the table. Story 4. When my wife and I were teenagers, we were about to have some fun on her bed. And teenage boy hormones were in full force, pants around my ankles, standing on the bed, and I take a step back and I slip. My foot goes through the gap between her mattress and her bed frame, and I fall backwards. My hand hits her ceiling fan, my back slides down her dresser, and my head hits her floor. So I'm laying on the floor in a daze figuring out what happened, and she's just on her bed laughing at me. To this day, we will have moments where she starts dying laughing just thinking about it. Story 5. My boyfriend and I had only been together for a few weeks at this point. We were having adult time at my house because we had a few hours before my younger brother got home from school. It was loud and fun when I saw a shadow pass my window. My room was next to the front door, so I saw when people came to the door. Brother had come home 2 hours early because it was a half a day. He shouts hi and starts down the stairs to make sure I was home. I hop off my boyfriend and dive under the blankets and yell, "Don't come in!" He pauses at the door, hears my boyfriend laughing his butt off, and throws the door open. Once he realized what was going on, he decided to make me super embarrassed. If you've ever seen the scene from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air when Will catches his mom in bed with a guy, "Mama, no!" That's what my brother did, and sat on my bed, effectively holding me hostage, talking to my boyfriend like I wasn't naked and tomato-faced. We still joke about it, but I don't think I'll ever live it down. Give your sister some privacy, man. Not only is that rude, but come on. You really want to barge in there with the potential of seeing things that you don't want to see? Not sure if this bedroom was equipped with one, but a simple door lock here would be a good idea. They're cheap and easy to use, but the payoff you get from not having your nosy brother walk in is priceless. In the comments, has anyone else had a similar annoying sibling who just couldn't stay out of your business? Story 6. My front teeth are crowns from a skateboarding accident when I was a kid. And in the military, I knocked one out and spent a month using denture glue to hold it in place until my dentist appointment. Under the crown was a small bit of tooth the crown attached to like a post. During that time, I had also just started a romantic relationship with my now wife and had not mentioned my hillbilly tooth. During an Australian encounter, my tooth fell out and I was too preoccupied to notice. When I returned from down under and we were kissing, she noticed. She pulled my head back up to see what was up and did a full-on double take at my mouth. I realized what happened and started trying to explain when she reached down, fumbled around at her bits, pulled out my tooth that had been stuck to her lady parts, and held it out to me quizzically. I almost died, but she still married me a few years later. Story 7. Freshman year in the dorms, one of the last days of the semester, a girl on a different floor invites me to come to her room and hang out. I obviously know what she's trying to do, so I ask her if her roommate is gone. She says she left for the semester, so I go down and go to her room, and we get started. We start talking a little, then start kissing, and then she starts going to work with her mouth. And in a matter of minutes, I hear a card hit the scanner, and the door opens to her roommate and her roommate's mom. Door swings open, and within seconds, they slam it shut. So I get dressed and walk out of the door while they're still just standing there in shock. As I walk away, I hear my roommate's mom start raising her voice saying, "Are you serious? You have got to be kidding me," and, you know, stuff like that. Walking back to my dorm on my floor, I'm not wearing boxers, and my shorts were slightly wet from her slobber. People definitely saw and knew what was up. As for the girl who I was with, her roommate's mom basically kept calling her bad names and didn't let her daughter dorm with her this semester. Story 8. My girlfriend and I used to go out driving some nights back when we were still in high school. We lived in a small town, so it was a reasonable activity to take part in every now and again. She and I drove out of town about 5 miles and went down this back road to a little unowned farm property and parked there, assured no one would see us. We got jiggy with it, and upon reaching just about our curfew, I went to start my car to drive us back home. But what I didn't realize was that my car did not have automatic lights, and I had not actually turned them off all the way. The battery was drained, and my car was not going to start on its own. I called all the friends I could think of to come help us so that we could just sneak back into town, but to no avail, I'd have to call my dad. Now, my dad, for the entirety of my life, has been someone I've been slightly afraid of waking up. He naps a lot and always seems to do so right around the time I need to ask him for something, and he always sounds angry when I do. I can only imagine how he must have felt when I called him at nearly 1 a.m., way past curfew at this point, to ask him to come save us. But he did. I had to give him directions to the spot we had picked specifically because it was hard to get to, and eventually he got there. I had to get out of the car, my girlfriend watching, and work with him to get my car jump-started again. Surprisingly, he didn't even seem all that angry, just got my car started and went home, and my girlfriend and I followed close behind. To my surprise, he never asked or grilled me about it, and either never told my mom or told her never to ask me about it either. Oddly, after that, I even felt like my dad treated me with an oddly heightened amount of respect, which hasn't dwindled since. I think the dad probably realized and respected something that his son did, which was, despite how scary and nerve-wracking it was to call his dad, his son did it anyway to get himself and his girlfriend out of a troubled situation. It takes a big man to do that, even when you know your dad might go ballistic. You might be a little proud, too, of the fact that his son has become a man, taking his girlfriend out to have some fun and be a stud. I think it's also very likely that the dad is purposely keeping all of this to himself in order to cash in on the embarrassment at a well-deserving moment in the future. Story 9. I was giving my boyfriend some pecker CPR under the sheets, and his grandmother knocked on his door and opened it. She saw us, and my boyfriend screamed at her to get out, but she kept looking. He still screamed at her to get the heck out after she left. When she did, he was really mad and embarrassed. I just started laughing and he joined in. And when his grandmother came back, I apologized to her about what happened and she said, "It's okay." Story 10. My high school girlfriend and I would often use her basement to fool around because it was mostly unfinished, so her family would never go down there. But it also had a couple comfy couches. One night, I was going down on her and we were positioned so that she was lying back on the couch and I was kneeling on the ground in front of her. She was loving it. I was loving it. Everything was great. And then all of a sudden, I felt a heavy weight drop onto my back, scaring the absolute crap out of me. I kind of jumped and tried to spin around, but ended up slamming my nose right into my girlfriend's stomach. Turns out her cat was curious what we were doing and decided that jumping up on my back would give him a better look. The cat bolted out of the room, and we started laughing almost to the point of tears. Story 11. My first New Year's with my then-girlfriend, now-wife, and I was still living with my mom. My mom decided to go to her boyfriend's house, so I took this opportunity to have the house to myself with my girlfriend. We got a couple bottles of champagne, and everything was going perfect. We had the house to ourselves, we had polished off 2 bottles of champagne, and were half naked. My mom had a pool table, which we had decided now would be a great time for me to teach my girlfriend pool. So I did the classic rom-com stuff, like position myself behind her and show her where to put her hands. And after a couple of rounds of me doing this, I take one of those opportunities to get us both of us completely naked and went for it while she was bent over the pool table. As this was going on faster than I can react, I hear keys in the front door and the door swings open. My girlfriend tries to run and hide, but she is very drunk, so she trips and falls. I already knew from the distance from the front door that there was no time, so I just put my hands to cover myself. My mom steps into view and sees me standing there next to the pool table and my girlfriend laying on the floor completely naked, accepting her fate and judgment. I mustered out a very awkward, "Hey, mom," and she says, oh, and then walks off. After my mom walked off, my girlfriend got up to cover up, which was hilarious because the closest thing that she could find to throw on was a poncho from my Tequila Man costume from Halloween. The best part of this was my girlfriend had never met my mom before this, so this was the first impression. Everything has a happy ending, though. As I stated in the beginning, we are now married, and my mom still has the card my wife made for her as an apology the next day. I feel like the mom handled that situation pretty well. Considering all the ways that she could have reacted, she kept her cool. She was probably more upset about the activity on top of the pool table. Replacing the felt on a pool table is a pain in the butt and expensive. I bet Mama just didn't want to see any stains or rips on that thing. I'm also glad that she can have a good daughter-in-law relationship, though, and that they can share a little laugh about this later. Story 12. I'm a janitor working in an honestly pretty run-down apartment complex, and we often have issues with vagrants or people loitering about the premises. Was just mopping up some crumbs of Pringles from the floor one evening when I heard a banging noise from outside. Naturally, I assumed it was another homeless dude sleeping in our dumpster. Got my broom ready, opened the lid with the most disparaging scowl on my face. Well, turns out it was just two, presumably, college-age teens going at it. Equipped with a GoPro and a laptop, she wore a big gamer headset and he had his sizable member between her cheeks, enjoying it. They mutely stared at me with their young and sinful puppy eyes, and I wanted to moralize or exclaim something rude, but really, I was just defeated. Story 13. Was friends with a German foreign exchange student when I was a freshman in college. Hung out a few times, but I never got the idea that she was into me. But then on the last day before she would go back to Germany, she called me up in the middle of the night and said that she wanted to hang out. Being a bored insomniac, I decided to agree. We walked around and talked for a bit, but she ended up inviting me back to her dorm. We ended up making out for a while, and I'm all fine and good. Eventually, she flat out tells me that she wants to have fun with me. I pretty much just flat out tell her that I don't want to lose my V card to someone right before they leave the country, and then I'll never see them again. She looks really surprised at first and then just assumes that I'm joking around. And when I tell her that I'm serious, she looks legitimately pissed off. Anyway, the girl decides to literally sit on me. At this point, I should mention that she is probably tipping the scales at about 300 pounds or so. Therefore, there is no way I am getting this large chick off of me on my own. She literally sits there for about an hour, telling me that she will only let me go if I agree to do it with her. Eventually, I out-stubborn her, and she finally just rolls off of me. I hadn't really given much thought to how messed up this was for years, but honestly, I think I've retold the story a few times later on in college as a funny story about a chick trying to force me to do something with her by holding me hostage under her. As a German chick, you should know better. There are rules to this. Come on now. You can't just assert your heavy dominance on this poor virgin and hold him hostage until he takes his pants off. This is borderline criminal for sure. And if you caught a charge the day before going back to Germany, they might not let you back in the country. Her reaction might be a German thing too. I have heard that they like to get their way and get upset when they don't. I'm glad this guy survived the encounter though with little or no injuries. Story 14. I had been active in high school and didn't have a guy go down on me until I went to college. We had the lights off and I heard him say, uh-oh, and take a long pause. Next thing I know, the lights are on and there's blood everywhere. The guy got a nosebleed on me and then panicked trying to clean it up with cheap paper towels. Yeah, ouch. I stayed for a few more hours and fell asleep. And when I woke up, remembered what had happened and tried to sneak out quietly but woke him up and bolted, dressed half on with no shoes. I went to the emergency exit of the dorm and ended up setting off the fire alarms. I then had to sprint into the woods as students came filing out of the building at 5 a.m. Story 15. I was going down on this girl and saw her do a finger phone and put it next to her ear and then heard, oh yeah, I'll tell him. Put her finger phone down, look me in the eyes as if pulled back, and I'll never forget the next words she said. That was Chief. He was calling to say that this ain't it. I was so embarrassed, not only from her bit, but also the fact that she felt the need to do it. We talked it out and got back down to it. Finish out, and everything goes good, so I head back home. My eye had started to get a little itchy, but I assumed it was just allergies. Nope, I'd gotten pink eye from it and had to explain that one to my parents. Story 16. After reading all these comments, I feel like I lucked out. The most embarrassing thing I ever experienced was accidentally getting roundhouse kicked in the face. My ex was on my stomach, and I was kissing her neck and back while getting into it. We're both naked, but haven't started doing it yet. She turns over and nails me in the face with her foot. I go down, try to shake it off, and get back on top of her, but every time I close my eyes, I lose my balance. I end up just laying next to her face down, and she just cuddles me. I feel better in the morning, so we finish what we started, but man, that really caught me off guard. Story 17. This happened when I was 15 years old. My cousins and their mom were invited to a two-day party at one of their friends, and they took me along. Now, I was already friends with the host's daughter, who was 5 years older than me. While everyone was having fun someplace else, the daughter and I had a better idea. We were in her room and in the middle of a session when my cousin's deeply Catholic mom had walked in on us. The door was directly in front of the bed. We were pretty vigorous in our activity at that point, my behind facing the door. She just gasped and ran away, leaving the door open. And after a bit of shock, we decided to close the door and continue having fun. 5 minutes later, and a voice started to say, "What did you guys do to upset?" And we didn't get to finish the sentence while the door was flung open once more. Her dad just stood there speechless. Finally, she exclaimed, "Dad, get the heck out!" After he left, it took me a while to get back in the mood, but we were determined to finish. By the time we got down, my cousins, my step-aunt, and my ride were all gone. At the end, her dad gave me a ride home, and that was the longest one-hour drive in my life. Not a word was spoken. When we got to my house, I just jumped out and mumbled a thank you before running inside. At least the dad got the answer he was looking for as to why you made your cousin's mom so upset. But again, I say door locks, people, door locks. They are handy, easy to install, and infinitely useful. I know some parents are always like, "I don't want my teenager locking their door." But after you walk in on your son or daughter in different stages of undress, doing the dirty, you immediately regret that rule. Obviously, teenagers are going to give in to their instincts and go at it whether you like it or not, so you might as well keep yourself from seeing something you can never unsee.